I love it when someone gives me something to work with. Hello everyone, I am Shane from Crystal Clear 101. Welcome back to the channel. I normally don't make these types of videos, but a few short weeks ago, I released a video briefly covering the HasLab Rattler. And while I do enjoy the fact that I did cover that video, cover that Rattler. What I do enjoy even more is when people decide to engage in the video, decide to comment. So to everyone who does comment, I do greatly appreciate it when you comment. It helps the algorithm, it helps more people find me. I just greatly appreciate it. In this case, I had one individual by the name of Crimson Cobra Commander decide to engage in that video. He left not one, not two, but three separate comments on that video. I figured I'd be nice and go ahead and engage in each one of those comments. So let me go ahead and get to the first comment, which was, "We just had a Joe vehicle. It's Cobra's turn. Next year we'll get Joe's vehicle. Plus, we just got the vamp." Okay, first off, let me go ahead and state for the comment, grammar, commas are your friend. They really help. Because otherwise, it looks like one long run-on sentence. And this has caused me to have to stop and actually think for a moment what you're trying to say. Now, with that being said, I was just going on what my personal thought was, what my personal thinking process was at the time. Which was why I was thinking it would have been something like a Mobat. Because I'm thinking Cobra Tank, Joe Helicopter, Joe Tank. That's what I was thinking. That was just my simple thought process. As for the second comment, it was, "And yes, I do think it's worth it." Well, in response to that, allow me to just go ahead and say, good, I'm glad that you think it's worth it. If you were to ask me that question now, do I think the Rattler is worth it? Honestly, I personally don't think it's worth it. I honestly think it should have been, at most, no more than what the Hess tank should have been, which was $299. Now, with that being said, I did state in that video that I would let y'all know if I decided I was going to back one or not. Well, in response to that, I will go ahead and say that I am actually highly considering backing at least one. I am a sucker for the Rattler, and I am a sucker for the A10 Thunderbolt 2. So, you may as well go ahead and just put me in the backing camp for the Rattler. And the third and final comment, and this is honestly the main reason I decided to make this video, was this one comment. Which is, "They're too big for store except online stores." Okay, where do I even start with this one? Okay, first off, spelling is your friend. The spelling of there that you use is the incorrect one for what you're wanting to use here. The way you spell to in conjunction with the sentence is the incorrect spelling of to that you're trying to use. But that's not the part that I'm even wanting to talk about here. As far as them being too big for store, well, let me explain in my own way why it wouldn't be too much of a stretch for these to be sold in stores. And I'm bringing this up for the simple fact that in that particular comment, in that particular thread with two other commenters, you decided to bring up both Walmart and Target. Since those are pretty much the main stores that we can go to nowadays that do carry toys. There's a reason I'm bringing that up. Both of them use what's called a 4-foot section. That explains each divide between each one, if you ever notice it. Each one is a 4-foot section. And to go along with that, you have two different size shelves that are for non-pegable items. Which are, you have 24-inch shelves for your larger items. And then you have the slightly smaller 18-inch shelves. Now, the reason I bring that up is I want to bring up, start listing off a series of both vehicles and playsets that have sold in retail chains and retail stores. And bear in mind, those shelves are highly modular. You can adjust them for whatever kind of product you're wanting to sell on them. All right. When I list these off, I am going to list the width of the box, followed by the height and the depth of the box, how thick it is. And bear in mind, the furthest back these shelves can go is 24 inches. All right, for the first one, and these are all vehicles and playsets that have sold at retail. The Jurassic Park Command Compound, 22 inches wide, 16 inches high, 13 inches in depth. The Kenner Star Wars Death Star playset, 22 by 14 by 16. The G.I. Joe USS flag, 45 by 30 by 11.5. The Star Wars Rogue One AT-ACT Walker, 27.01 by 15 by 6.5. The Star Wars Legacy Collection Millennium Falcon. Now this one I have actually bought at retail. 26 by 23.63 by 9.25. The Star Wars Legacy Collection AT-AT Imperial Walker, 26.75 by 15.24 by 8.27 inches. Now, all of those have been sold at retail on the shelves. And there is one more that I have forgot to mention, and it's quite literally the big one. And before I do forget, I do need to give a special shout out to It's Chad for giving me the size dimensions for the G.I. Joe Defiant. He was able to get me the width and the height of the bots. So special shout out to you. You are awesome. That has really helped me. And I have definitely saved the best one for last. And this one has sold at retail. Granted, this was back in 1987, but it sold at retail. And that is the G.I. Joe Defiant Space Shuttle. The bots for that one. I unfortunately don't have the depth for that box, but we are talking 28.5 inches wide by 47 inches tall. That is a big box, and that sold at retail back in 1987. Now, I do have listed here the bots dimensions for two HasLabs. And if you're wondering which HasLabs I got listed here, the War for Cybertron Siege Unicron, 23.25 by 23.5 by 23.25. That is the size of Unicron's bots. That would be the uppermost edge size-wise to go on a shelf. But it theoretically could go on a shelf. And the HasLab Hiss Tank. 23.25 by 14.375 by 13.125. Yes, it would be a reasonably wide box, but it could fit on a shelf. Now, what I told you was the entire Hiss Tank box with the extra figures and all that. That's the size of that box. Now, why am I bringing all that up? It's the simple fact that virtually any of these classified series vehicles that are being sold through HasLab, theoretically, could be sold on a shelf. If you just simply strip away the electronic features, which, honestly, I really don't see a purpose for the electronics other than, you know, maybe some photography purposes, other than some display purposes. But I mean, other than that, if you just strip the electronics down, just get the cost of the vehicles down, they should sell at retail without really any issue. And as far as big box items that are being sold between Target and Walmart, I did a little compilation here. As far as the criteria for these two videos I'm going to present, as far as big box items being sold at retail right now, they have to meet the following criteria. Either A, the physical box must take up a fair amount of real estate. B, the item in the box must be physically large when assembled. C, must be moderately expensive. Or D, any one of them can be all of the above. Now, with that being said, Target Edition. And now, Walmart Edition. I'm sure those two videos were overkill, but it kind of proves my point that they wouldn't be too big for shelves at a local retail store. Oh, and by the way, when someone does make a counter argument to what you're trying to say, please try and watch your language. Because I know you called one of my fellow subscribers an asshole. I do try to watch the language on this channel because I do know some younger viewers do watch this. So I humbly ask that you try to watch your language on here. And with that being said, to Crimson Cobra Commander, I do appreciate you taking the time to comment on that video. And for me, I've actually personally enjoyed responding to your comments on this. And if you stuck with me up to this point, thank you for watching this video. If you are new to this, be sure to like this video. Be sure to subscribe if you are not already subscribed. And be sure to turn on that bell so you can get notifications for when I upload new videos. And with that being said, you have an awesome day. Take care.